Hello, hello, and welcome to the Feed My Sheep Foundation Bible Study Video Channel. Today we are going to take a look into studying the Holy Spirit and the manifestations of the Holy Spirit on this video, because the Holy Spirit has been pressing down upon me to do a Bible study video regarding this. And again, we're going to be talking about the manifestations of the Holy Spirit. We're going to take that Bible study from 1 Corinthians chapter 12. Now, this is a book that I have not had an opportunity to do a Bible study on yet, and this may be the reason why the Holy Spirit is pushing it out and forward right now, because it's very important to know what the manifestations of the Holy Spirit is, so that we can know when we see it in operation. We know, you know, have discernment to be able, and discernment is one of the, discerning of different spirits, I do believe, yep. Discernment is one of the essential, techniques that the Holy Spirit has, that it utilizes through us as we operate in it. So, again, we're doing a Bible study on the manifestations of the Holy Spirit. So as we go ahead and get into this, 1 Corinthians chapter 12, it says, "Now concerning spiritual gifts, brothers," okay, so these would be people, again, this is Paul, because he's the majority of the New Testament ministering, I want to say, discipleship was done by Paul. Once he became a converted citizen of heaven, he went forward preaching the gospel and converting others. And so all the ministry is the majority. Well, all of it is about him through the New Testament. That's recorded, I should say, in the Holy Bible. Okay. So anyway, chapter 12, 1 Corinthians. And he's talking to the brothers, those that have been converted. He said, "I would not have you ignorant," okay, because God does not want us to not know things about heaven, not know things about him, not know things about the Holy Spirit. He does not want us to not know things about the Holy of Holies. And sometimes our ignorance, it can hold us back. It really can. He says, verse 2, "You know that ye were Gentiles," okay, "carried away unto these idols, even as you were led." Okay, so they used to be Gentiles, led on, and he called them dumb idols. "Wherefore I give you to understand that no man speaks by the Spirit of God. He calls Jesus a curse, and that no man can say that Jesus is the Lord but by the Holy Ghost." Okay, so the Holy Ghost is what he's telling us is the only way. And when someone is converted into the Holy Ghost, into the kingdom of heaven, that is the only way that a person will be able to say that Jesus Christ is Lord, because through the power and the presence of the Holy Spirit, that's what the Holy Spirit knows, and it's only going to confess and speak the truth through you. Okay, so verse 4 says, "Now there are diversities, different kinds of gifts, but the same Spirit," okay, "and there are differences of administrations," okay, "but the same Lord." And there are diversities is the word they're using, but there are different operations. But it's the same God which works all and in all. Now, verse 7 gives us the word that we're looking at, "but the manifestation," okay, "of the Spirit is given to every man to profit with all," okay. "For one, it is given by the Spirit," and that is to profit in all and all. Okay, the whole body of Christ is to profit from all of the gifts of God and the Holy Spirit. He says, "For to one person is given the Spirit of the word of knowledge." Okay, so through the Spirit, the Holy Spirit, that's one gift that we see that was given and that will manifest. That's a manifestation. I'm going to use that word because it does use words of gifts, but we're going to stick with manifestation, because what we are, our Bible study is about, is the manifestations of the Holy Spirit. So that the word of wisdom is another manifestation of the Holy, Holy Ghost, Holy Spirit. Because the word of wisdom, the Holy Bible, you know, the Holy Spirit and the Bible, the Holy Word, they are the same, basically. Okay, and then he says, to another, the word of knowledge. Okay, so to be able to know and understand the Word of God and have understanding in the heavens and the Word of God and this Holy Spirit. And he says, to another, faith. Okay, so these things will be manifested through the individual that has the Holy Spirit. This is the proof, you could basically say, if you want to say, this is what it looks like on the inside out, coming out of a person. Okay, and another's the gifts of healing. Okay, and this is all by the same Holy Spirit, is just telling us. Okay, they will be able to heal. Gifts of healing. And however that gift may come, that gift may come through a revelation through the Word of God. You know, because the gifts of healing can come in many ways. It could come, yes, touching someone, laying hands on them, of course. But it tells us right here, gifts, which is plural, of healing. So there are different gifts of healing. Singing. You know, wherever the anointing is, that can pull a yoke off of someone and heal them. You know, wherever God has placed that anointing in a person. Because we know David, he was a great, and he was instrumental. Was it the harp that he played? And it was basically, you might as well say it was anointed, because it warded off evil spirits off of people when they heard it. Okay, and some people have that effect through their singing, through their talking, through their voice. God has given them that. Okay, and so gifts of healing can come through that also. Gifts of touch. Just, you never know how the gift of the healing is going to come, but it's going to manifest through the Spirit. You know, again, through an individual who has the Holy Spirit. So to another, working of miracles. Miracles is another manifestation, okay, of the person with the Holy Spirit, the miraculous, the supernatural, you know, things to manifest that, you know, you can't make happen in the natural. One of those things would be just the incident that happened yesterday when we were on our Bible study in the book of Psalms on a video that we did, and it was Psalms 92, okay? And then there was Psalms 92, and then verse 10, where the Holy Spirit led me to draw into, and it was speaking about how the Lord will exalt the horn of his anointed, okay, like a unicorn. And then the Holy Spirit led me yesterday to a unicorn pad is what it is, for the mouse that you actually stroll the mouse from the computer upon. It's a pad. So anyway, that pad was the picture of a unicorn. And that's what the Holy Spirit led me to yesterday. So that was like a miraculous event. That was something out of the supernatural, because I didn't put that unicorn, I didn't put the unicorn there. How, and the Holy Spirit led me, you know, to the Bible study Psalm 92. So it was just a combination of the Holy Spirit confirming the Word of God, confirmation of the Word of God, and the Word of God, someone speaking and saying the Word of God, and then the Holy Spirit confirming it through someone else. You know, because God will confirm His Word, the words that come out of the messenger's mouth, if He wants to do that, or if He needs to do that. He does confirm it. Okay, and so at each time, in instance with any individual, that's a miraculous event. That's a supernatural presence and power. Okay, and so that is another manifestation, proof, we can say, that that person is Holy Spirit filled. They have been converted into the kingdom. Okay, then there's another prophecy, is a manifestation. Okay. okay, to prophesy something, to just up and say it, because that's how prophecy works. I don't understand this other stuff. But I mean, to my knowledge and my own experience with prophecy, I've never known myself to be able to know when I'm getting ready to prophesy, okay? Because again, it's heaven speaking through me, prophetically speaking something that's coming to pass. And God has not given me in any instance when I've actually had that encounter happen. He's never let me know ahead of time, okay, you're going to speak this and say that and this is going to come to pass. That has not been what has happened. It was just certain things that were said, and then that may be your same experience. Okay, so just like the word of God is prophetic. God is prophetic, okay? So that's another manifestation of the Holy Spirit. Then there's speaking in tongues, different types of tongues, praying in the Holy Spirit, praying in an unknown tongue, okay? And some people can pray in different languages. Some people can pray in a language, the heavenly language that is just to the Heavenly Father, where they're just speaking unto the Heavenly Father and praying. Let me see, and to actually take you where that is, because that is right over here. Okay, that's in same book, 1 Corinthians chapter 14. For he that speaks in an unknown tongue he that speaks in an unknown tongue speaks not unto men, but unto God. For no man understands him. So howbeit in the Spirit he speaks mysteries, okay? Many times praying in the Holy Spirit will call forth angels into heaven on your account for whatever it is you may need them for right then and there, you know? So, you know, because praying in the Holy Ghost pulls in the different tongues, because that's the language of heaven, it's communicating with heaven and letting you know what you need from heaven right then and there when you begin to operate in it. Okay, then there's the interpretation of tongues, okay? Some people can't interpret tongues. And again, I've had that experience, and I didn't know I was going to have that experience. Every time I've ever had any type of experience, supernatural experience from heaven through the power of the Holy Spirit, I was not ever made aware of it by God. You know, he didn't reveal it, just happened. And then, you know, you have the testimony that you have that experience. So, and I did have that experience. So, verse 11 says, but all these work that one and the self same Spirit, okay, work all these work from the Holy Spirit, dividing to every man severally as he will. For as the body is one, that's all the body of Christ. All these gifts belong completely and totally over to all of us in heaven, because they are a part of who we are since we've become a part of heaven. Okay, so then all the members of that one body, being many, are one body. So also is Christ. For by one Spirit are we all baptized into one body, whether we are Jews, Gentiles, bond or free, and have been all made to drink into one Spirit. And that's, this verse is just giving confirmation too, because on another video I may mention that you can come out of yourself as whatever your nationality is, whatever ethnicity you are, you know, whatever race you come from, you, whenever you become Holy Spirit filled, you are a new citizen of heaven, okay? Your ethnicity is heavenly. That's your new that's who you are. But again, you're in the earth, how God sent you here in the earth, in that body, in that nationality, in that ethnicity, okay? Because that's where he wanted his Spirit to be at that particular purpose, place, and time. And so that's why he placed it in whomever, in that individual, for them to have it. Okay? Again, because I've said again, and we'll say again many times over and over, you know, that God places us in the earth with the type of body and the type of ethnicity and where he wants his Spirit to be, and how, you know, however he wants it to maneuver in the earth, he does it. It's all about him and how he wants to orchestrate his plan and his will. So then it says, for the body is not one member but many. Okay? And then so this whole chapter 12 is the chapter, but with emphasis on verse 7, the manifestations, because it goes into all the manifestations from verse 7 all the way to verse 13, okay, and or 14, but you can actually read the whole book of Corinthians in this whole chapter too. And it'll give you great insight. And then, let me take you over here to this part too. It says, now ye are the body of Christ, and members in particular. God has set some in the church, okay, as the body of Christ. And first apostles, second prophets, third teachers. Then after that, miracles, gifts, healings, helps, government, different types of tongues, and are all apostles, are all prophets, and are all teachers, are all workers of miracles. And they all have gifts of healing, and do all speak with tongues, and do all interpret. Okay, but desire earnestly the best gift, he says. And yet, I show I love to you the more excellent way. Okay, but again, the reason for the particular study was manifestations of the Holy Spirit. And we went over all of those in this chapter, 1 Corinthians chapter 12, starting with verse 7 and then really going into it in verse 8. Word of wisdom, word of knowledge, faith, gifts of healing, miracles, prophecy, discerning of spirits. I'm sorry, I left that out. That's what discernment. That's another one. I don't know how I left that out, but I did. I stepped over it. And then different types of tongues, praying in tongues, and another interpretation of the tongues. Okay? So that is what, whenever you see someone, that's a manifestation of the Holy Spirit. I'll just leave it like that. Okay? So, that's going to conclude our Bible study on the manifestation of the Spirit, part one, because I do believe we're going to do a part two. God bless you, and I will speak with you and study with you again as we continue to go forward, studying in the Word of God, receiving revelations, wisdom, and knowledge from our Holy Heavenly Father who has created us to walk in His image. All right? God bless you.